life growing up, home was never in the United States. We would always hear about back home, and we'd always want to go back home, and everything that they did was something that was back home.
Nadira Weiss describing growing up Palestinian American in California. The message also comes through in this soulful photo and sound of Lubha Murar.
I think for me, being here in the U.S., we grew up, it's like there is nothing but home. That's kind of like what we grew up with. Like there is nothing but Palestine.
The two are part of a mixed media presentation called Home Away From Home, Little Palestine by the Bay by Najib Joe Hakim, who says his exhibit aims to let Palestinians speak for themselves.
Growing up in this country, they were always spoken for by experts or Israelis or Americans or whoever. And I thought it was about time that people told their stories in their own voices.
The participants in this exhibit all live in the western United States in the San Francisco Bay Area. They represent only the tiniest percentage of the 250,000 Palestinians in the United States. But the feelings they express are universal.
Understanding the places, because you see them on a map, you don't get the smell, you don't get the feel, you don't get the touch. Seeing it with your own eyes is truly a difference. But I will tell you for myself, I really like it there. I felt at home there.
Palestinian-American Zaina Hazam says the immigrant experience is common in the United States, but those coming from Palestine feel it differently.
This is another layer. There's a layer of feeling this strong attachment to Palestine. There's a layer of feeling American yet outside American society. There's a feeling of trying to assimilate but also trying to be an individual and trying to keep your identity.
Born and raised in the U.S., Noor Shaeb says there has been no struggle to retain her family's culture.
We have very tight communities, tight-knit communities where I'm from, and we still incorporate the culture. We have the debke, the food, the language, of course, and of course, we still have that sense of Palestinian. I want to say we want people to know that we still exist, that we're still here.
Noor knows life is easier in the U.S. than in Palestine, perhaps, but like other Palestinian Americans in the exhibit, she always hopes for more. Reporting for Bahrain TV, I'm Marty Johnson, Washington.